this video, we are about to discuss Class 6, Term 3, Unit 1, Magnetism. This is Part 2. Topics to be discussed: magnetic and non-magnetic materials, magnetic poles, finding directions with a magnet. In the last video, we discussed about the discovery of magnets and different shapes of the magnet. Here, the first topic that we are about to discuss is magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Magnetic and non-magnetic materials, substances which are attracted by magnet, are called magnetic substances. Iron, cobalt, nickel are magnetic substances. So what are magnetic substances, or what are magnetic materials? The substances which are attracted by the magnet are called magnetic substances. So the examples of magnetic substances are iron, cobalt, nickel, and these are the things that are called as magnetic materials or magnetic substances. These substances will get attracted by a magnet. So these are called as magnetic substances. So what are non-magnetic materials? Substances which are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic substances. So we have more examples for non-magnetic substances. Paper, plastic are called non-magnetic substances. Even the wood, rubber, all these things are also non-magnetic substances. So substances which are attracted by magnet are called magnetic substances. Substances which are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic substances. So what are all the magnetic substances? Yes, the magnetic substances are iron, nickel, and cobalt. What are the non-magnetic substances? The non-magnetic substances are paper, plastic, wood, and rubber. Magnetic poles. Place some iron fillings on the paper. Place the bar horizontally in the fillings and turn it over a few times. Now lift the magnet. So we are placing some iron fillings, that is small pieces of iron, very small pieces of iron on a paper, and you are placing a bar magnet horizontally and you are turning it over a few times and you are now lifting the magnet. What happens? What do you see? Which part of the magnet has more iron fillings sticking to it? Which part of the magnet has almost no fillings sticking to it? So you can observe this. This is how the iron fillings are attracted to a magnet. The parts of the magnet, those attract the largest amount of iron fillings, are called as its poles. So which part of the magnet has attracted the large amount of iron fillings? Both the ends of the bar magnet. The attractive force of the magnet is very large near the two ends. These two ends are called its poles. So you can see here, the two ends of the magnet are called as its poles. This is called a south pole and this is called the north pole. If you have a horseshoe magnet or any other type of magnet at home, find the position of its poles by this experiment. In this experiment, we will be using iron fillings. So in experiments with magnets, you will need to use iron fillings again and again. You can do this by placing a magnet in a pile of sand and turning it around in the sand. Hope many of us has played this game. Yes. So the small pieces of iron present in the sand will stick to the magnet. If you cannot find sand, you can look for the iron pieces in the clayed soil. So you can see, if you don't have iron fillings, you can collect some small pieces of iron and they will serve the purpose as well. So you can take a pile of sand, or you can take small pieces of iron, or also you can look into the clay soil where you have iron pieces. So if you have a magnet, place them and see which ends are getting attracted more and find the poles of that magnet. Finding directions with a magnet. Tie a piece of thread to a center of a bar magnet and suspend it. Note in which direction the magnet stops. So we are going to find the direction with the magnet. So we are tying a piece of thread to the center of the bar magnet and you are hanging it. So note down in which direction the magnet stops. Draw a line on a sheet of cardboard or the table along the direction in which the bar magnet stops. A line parallel to the bar magnet. Turn the magnet gently and let it come to stop again. Repeat it 3 or 4 times. So you are drawing a line on a sheet of a cardboard or on the table along the direction in which the bar magnet stops. So where that is a line parallel to the bar magnet. Now turn the magnet gently and let it come to stop again. So you are repeating it for 3 to 4 times and see how the magnet is getting stopped. Does the bar magnet stop in the same direction each time? In which direction does the magnet stop every time? This is roughly the north-south direction. So you would have observed that bar magnets stop in the same direction each time. And in which direction does the magnet stop every time? It is stopping at the north-south direction. The end of the magnet that points to the north is called North Pole. The end of the points to the south is called the South Pole. A freely suspended magnet always comes to rest in the north-south direction. Do you know, the directive property of magnets has been used for centuries to find directions. Around 800 years ago, the Chinese discovered that a suspended lodestone stops in the north-south direction. So we are using this directive property of magnets for centuries to find directions. So around 800 years ago, the Chinese, they only discovered that a suspended lodestone stops in the north-south direction, and they used it in the ships for finding the directions. Chinese used these lodestones to find directions. The navigators of that country used to keep a piece of lodestone suspended in their boats, and during a storm or mist, they used the lodestone to locate directions. So the navigators, that is the people who sail in the boat, they used the lodestone. They will use to keep the lodestone suspended. They will hang the lodestone in their boats, and so that during a storm or mist, they used the lodestone to locate the directions, to find the directions. So Chinese are the one used these lodestones to find directions. Summary of the video, we discussed about magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Magnetic materials are the substances which are attracted by a magnet are called magnetic materials or magnetic substances. We saw that iron, nickel and cobalt are magnetic substances. Non-magnetic materials or non-magnetic substances are the substances which are not attracted by a magnet. They are called as non-magnetic materials or non-magnetic substances. We saw plastic, rubber and many more things as examples for non-magnetic materials. And we discussed about the magnetic poles and finding directions with a magnet. This is to be continued. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.